Welcome aboard the Jeanneau 57, hull number 106. It's a 2013 model, delivered to New Zealand late 2012 and handed over to its first owner, January 2013. I'm Jason Snashel of Ariki Yacht Sales and Ariki Marine in Ariki Marina, Auckland, New Zealand. And this Jeanneau 57's name is MIMU, and she's for sale. I'm in the cockpit of the Jeanneau 57. As you can see, it's quite a large cockpit. It's the longest and widest volume cockpit of any of the yachts of this size. Moving forward, you can see all the cushions and furnishings that are from the factory. So just moving a little bit further forward in the cockpit, you can see where all the halyards lead back into the cockpit. We've got electric winches on both port and starboard with fast and slow speed, and they're brought to us by Harken. All the keyboards are labeled, so you've got reefing back here, the outhaul, halyards for the mainsail, all the headsails. Further aft of the cockpit, come right back to the helms, we've got German main sheeting. So the main sheet has one continuous line from both port side all the way through to starboard, and these are the main sheet winches, one on port, one on starboard. Again, they have fast and slow speed. As this boat was selected with asymmetrical spinnaker rigging, we've got the asymmetric spinnaker winches down aft, and again they both have slow and fast speeds. So that's six electric winches in the cockpit, all electric. On the aft starboard push pit, we've got the barbecue. This is a Kiwi Sizzler installed here in New Zealand, essential item for New Zealand. Coming across the back, we've got John Boys for the Category 1 offshore certification. This boat comes complete with a full complement of Cat 1 gear. In about a week's time, the boat's on its way to Fiji, so we've already got it set up. EPIRB on the stern here as well. Got a satellite telephone antenna. It's an Italian. The satellite telephone's Thrane and Thrane. It's also hooked up to Wi-Fi, so when offshore you can send emails through the SAT system. We've put it on the transom of the boat rather than in the rigging for the unlikely occasion when the mast falls down, so you'll still have satellite communications at that point. Coming across to the electronics on each helm station, we have the sailing equipment on this port side. It's all Raymarine instruments, autopilot on both port and starboard helm, and the instruments for wind and you name it. You can set these up as you need. Depth, wind, speed, has it all. On the port side here, we have the control for the passer rail, which is out the stern. You can see the passer rail here, and simple push of the button enables us to move the passer rail in and out as we need. When you're in the marina, in Europe, in the Mediterranean, essential item. On the starboard helm station, we have a little bit more for the engine controls. We have the throttle, we have an anchor chain counter, and this will pull the anchor in and out as well. Bow thruster control, that's a max power bow thruster. And I have to note that the helms are all carbon fiber, and that was our custom option when this boat was built. It's worth noting that when this boat was released from the factory, it was the most highly specced Jeanneau 57 in the world. And we put a number of custom options on the boat, such as these carbon fiber helms, and also the equipment in the rigging. We've got spreaders that run up and down in the rigging to light up the rig at night. You'll notice on the rig at the moment, we've got the mainsail off. That's just getting some work done to it before we head offshore next week. Completing the helm station equipment here, we've got all your lighting controls. This is the spreader lights, as well as courtesy lights in the cockpit. There's nice dim LEDs in the cockpit, the spreader lights, a deck light for the bow when working on the bow at night time, whether it be anchoring or out at sea, and also nav light controls. And right in the middle here, able to be seen from both sides of the both helms, you've got the E165 Raymarine screen, 16 inch. This is connected to all the electronics. When you dim any one of these electronic items, the whole lot will dim together. So it's great for when you're offshore at night. Downstairs in the nav station, we've also got an E125 12 inch display that's connected to all of this equipment as well. So you can passage plan on either item. Both screens have Wi-Fi capability. So with your iPad or your Android device, if you have Navionics app on the equipment, you can try even do your chart plotting on that iPad at home, here, wherever you are. When you come on board the boat, it will automatically synchronize, so that all your passage plans, all your favorite fishing spots and sailing spots will come up on the Raymarine equipment. We have radar as well up in the rigging. The radar's HD, 16 kilowatt, great for offshore again with chirp. Moving back across to the port side helm station, we have hydraulic backstays. The hydraulic backstay control is just here, and that's easily released and pumped up by a handle that's located in this locker. You've got fresh water washdown and emergency bilge pump when all else fails. So here we are on the bow of the Jeanneau 57. As you can see, the owner of MIMU has put the dinghy on the bow. We've got stainless steel deck fitted mounting below the dinghy to hold it in place, and tie downs on deck. The dinghy is a brand new 2015 Zodiac Cadet 310, so it's 3.1 meters long and can take 4 to 5 people and some luggage. The outboard engine's a 20 horsepower 4-stroke Honda, and it's fully covered with a outboard cover as an accessories cover, OCA. The dinghy's having a brand new cover made for it as we speak, and that'll be made by Doyle Sails and Covers of New Zealand. Just moving further forward to the rigging and sailing equipment, we've got the standard headsail. It's 135% Jeanneau from the factory fitted. It's got a hydraulic furler, which is operated back at the helm station. The sails are made by Incidents, who have been making the sails for Jeanneau for many years. A little bit further forward than that, than this furler, you'll also see the fitting for asymmetrical spinnaker, which is from the factory also. The asymmetric was purchased here in New Zealand. It's made by Doyle's, New Zealand. And the furler, we just clipped that when the sails packed away. The furler's clipped here. Furling lines run down the port side of the boat, right back to the cockpit for furling it up. And the sail is kept, it can be kept in the sail locker down here through this large hatch on the foredeck. But on this particular Jeanneau 57, this cabin is also the skipper's cabin. So it has a double bed with access to the cabin from the port side guest room. So there is still storage underneath the bed. So that's where sails can go. But at the moment, the asymmetric spinnaker is in the dinghy locker down the stern. So you will notice the inner forestay. This has been added locally here in New Zealand also. It's got a Barmar manual furler, and the sail and rigging has been added by Doyle's New Zealand. We added this inner forestay staysail furler for basically sailing while we've got the dinghy on the bow. The dinghy won't be doesn't impede the tacking of this staysail, and you'll see that the standard Jeanneau, that's 135%, that does touch this dinghy, so it's best to be used when the dinghy's not on the bow. That's it. So we're on the port side of the push pit on the 57, and one thing we'd missed is the outboard engine. So this little contraption was installed here in New Zealand, It basically takes the outboard engine on a bracket here and enables one person to pull the dinghy out of the dinghy garage, stick it in the water, and then put the outboard engine onto the dinghy by themselves. It's got a harness underneath the outboard cover, like this. And connect it up like so. And then we have a jammer here that enables us to push the outboard engine out on the gantry and then drop it down to the dinghy level. Put the jammer on so that it's not going to drop any further. Then I can walk down and connect the outboard engine up to the dinghy myself. This was designed by the owner of this boat basically because he found himself needing to do these maneuvers by himself. So pretty much everything on the boat is designed for the owner-operator to do by himself. If you've got another person helping you, it just makes it all the more easier. Again, coming forward in the cockpit, we've got the luxury center cockpit table made out of teak. We've oiled the teak here, and you'll see that it's got a nice little compartment for beverages. And this one here is not refrigerated. On this side, it is refrigerated, and you can see just how many beers you can fit in. It's also drink holders, stainless steel drink holders throughout the boat for whatever drink you might be drinking, cocktails, beers. And up forward, we've got something I didn't point out before with the halyards. Little halyard hiding compartments here so that when you finish sailing for the day, you can shove all your halyards in there without your guests getting their hands caught. Again, still in the cockpit, we have the factory fitted Dodger and factory fitted Bimini. The Bimini is really well designed. It pushes right out to the edge of the cockpit. It doesn't just stop at the edge of the seating for maximum sun protection and rain and drizzle. You'll see up in the Bimini, we've got LED lighting sewn into the Bimini, which provides some really good lighting when entertaining at night time. And you can see the sneaky little wires running down inside the stainless steel and down into the boat. And that's all controlled by switches on the dashboard. Up forward on the Dodger, it's a very solid Dodger with leather wound stainless steel bars for holding onto. And there's also little compartments that can be unzipped, either rolled up or taken away completely if it's a beautiful sunny day and you want some wind running through the cockpit. If you want to put it down completely, it takes a matter of seconds. You just have to pull a couple of pins out of the stainless and then push it all forward, and it all sits into this little recess up forward. And there's even a bolt rope here to put a cover over the Dodger when it's down. And the Bimini will also move back to the backstays, and it has a little cover that'll zip up across it, and the cover will basically stay in a horseshoe at the backstay point, so the whole boat's uncovered again. They're coming down into the saloon of the Jeanneau 57. This boat has the aft owner's cabin and two forward guest cabins. That means you have the one door on the starboard side of the companionway through to the aft cabin, and on the port side you have no door, so you have an unobstructed galley, which is a really nice feature. In the galley we have everything you need, more stuff than you'll probably have at home. We have ice maker on the aft bulkhead, lots of storage, plenty of cupboard space. This Jeanneau 57 we've upgraded to the electric galley. The standard option is to have gas, but if you don't like gas on the boat or you prefer to cook on electric, that's what we've got here. It's got a range hood so that all the smells get pulled out of the cooking area for your kettle, toaster. It's got a fridge and freezer, separate compartments. And the front door access to the fridge as well. Underneath these storage locker cupboards here, we've got a microwave on one side, plates, cutlery, everything you need for the family. It's got New Zealand, Australia power and power points being built for our markets. On the sink, we have fresh water, and we also have a salt water tap. Remove these panels so you access the washing, the sink, the cutting board, and replace them when you're finished cooking and cleaning for the day. Drying rack on the starboard side, put all your wet items, cleaning gear down there, and there's a drain at the bottom. And down at your knees in the sink, we also have under the sink, we have a Electrolux dishwasher. Underneath the galley floor, plenty of storage. I'll show you under this one first. So you've got plastic bins down here that are quite deep and full of all the necessities that you have, the dry stores, cleaning gear, and access on this other one to your batteries and all of your Seacox for the main engine. Main engine's under the companionway, we'll get to that in a minute. Generator is underneath the floor here, and all your air conditioning and bilge equipment is forward of the generator. Just moving forward in the saloon, we've got the seating area here for 8. At a squeeze you could fit 10. The table is electric, moves up and down with your button over here by the chart table. That means you can move it down to be a cafe style coffee table, or you can open it up to be a dinette for the family. These chairs conveniently move and fit exactly underneath the table, and if you are going offshore, you can move the table down to the point where it sits on these seats and they will not move, which is a great feature for heading offshore. On the port side of the boat, we have a nice settee. This settee has a lot of features to it. It's not just a settee, but underneath we have the liquor cabinet, fine wines, glasses, and champagne. And if you are entertaining, you can put your nuts and your martini down on this little bar top. When you're done, it's easily put away. On the underneath the rest of the settee, we have a modular desalator water maker. Without pulling the whole couch apart, this is the control panel. It runs on both 12 volts or 24 volts, and also on the shore power or genset at 230 volts. All your instruments are here telling you how much water it's making. It does 100 liters per hour. So when you're running the engine, it's a good idea to have the water maker going to fill up your tanks when you're offshore and you need the water. Another engineering piece of equipment on the starboard side. This boat has had the option selected for one of the water tanks to be turned into diesel. That option gives you this transfer pump here. So you fill the usual diesel tanks and then use the pump, this control panel, to transfer the diesel into the water tank that has been converted to diesel. That does mean you've got less holding capacity for water, but that's why you have the desalator to fill the water tanks as you go. This boat has enough fuel to motor itself to Fiji or Australia from New Zealand. Part of the nerve center on the starboard side aft is our chart table. The other E125 Raymarine screen with radar, chart plotter, fish finder, and link to the Fusion equipment and stereo. All of your all the buttons we need to turn on the cabin lights, turn on the water pumps, and everything that's 12 volt. And all our 240 volt switches are easily accessed from this little cupboard here. We can start the generator by simply heating it up for a few seconds, priming it, and you can hear the primer going if you're where I am, and then starting the genset. Again, the primer works while you're trying to start the genset, so it takes about 10 seconds to run, and you'll hear it charge up in a second. There's three bus bars. This is why we have the three connections, and all of these have been wired so that they'll run off the shore power. So you have both air conditioning bus bars, as well as the inverter bus bar, which is the bottom one, and then the other equipment bus bar, which does things like the electric galley and the air conditioning, battery chargers, etc. So I'm not sure if it'll come out on the video, but the generator's running now. Generator is located right below me here, just forward of the companionway stairs, and I can barely feel any vibration and any noise where I'm standing, which means you can sit in the saloon and still watch television while you've got the genset running. Just to turn that off, it's quite easy to just press the stop button and you're done. Going into the more of the electronics, we've got the VHF radio. We also have an extension to the VHF, which is up on the starboard helm, so you can use the radio up there. There's air conditioning controls all through the boat, and all the charts for this end of the world. One thing we missed, pretty important in a saloon, is television, and that's neatly tucked away in this compartment. It's easy to just press the button and have it pop up, ready for everybody to watch TV. You can see this from the settee, both on the port side of the boat, as well as the settee that's all over on the starboard side, so everyone can see the television. This television's also connected to the Raymarine equipment, so you can have the chart, radar, fish finder, whatever you like, running on the television while you're offshore, and people can see where you're going. When you're done with it, again, just press the down button, TV goes away, and we can cover it up. There's Bose surround sound throughout the boat. It gives you surround sound for the television, surround sound for your DVDs, and surround sound for your stereo as well. Okay. So now we're in the aft owner's cabin of Jeanneau 57106 MIMU. You can see the full beam owner's cabin down aft is really nice, very luxurious, with the 2013 model year upgrade of trim. This bed is genuinely as long as the one you'll have at home, king size. Beautiful inner sprung mattress, and we also have the option for the slats underneath the mattress to stop any mold and mildew. You'll see where you're looking right now, the hanging locker, it's full length, and if I shut the door, you'll see that it's quite a good size with a light inside. Must note, this boat's ready to go offshore, so there's a little bit of gear in every locker, but a little bit of a dressing table here for the ladies, or a desk. We also have the satellite telephone here for making the calls when you're offshore, and this is where it'll ring. It's also connected to the telephone system throughout the boat, so you can use it in other cabins. Looking forward, you can see we've got a flat screen TV with a stereo and DVD player that's connected, and there's more Bose speakers in this cabin for surround sound. On the starboard side, you've got the bathroom with a separate toilet and shower, and the shower has a screen door. next week's trip. Bed lamps on either side and escape hatches to the cockpit area. Those escape hatches can also be opened, obviously, for a little bit of ventilation through the boat. If you open the hatch on the forepeak above the skipper's cabin and open these ones at the stern, it'll flush completely clean, fresh air through the boat in a matter of minutes. So we're now at the forward end of the saloon, looking into the two forward cabins. Port side, we've got a twin cabin bunk room. On the starboard side, double bed for two people to share. VIP cabin on the starboard side has its own bathroom up forward, and that's private with a television, air conditioning system through the cabin. Also has DVD and stereo. Now this bunk is quite interesting because we can actually extend it and make it wider. You can see the infill here. The bunk will come out, become a much wider double, almost king size in width, and we can remove the center timber divider here and store the timber panels. You can see that they're built like a jigsaw. There's eight panels. We can put these underneath the bed and connect this cabin to the port side cabin to make one large cabin. The bathroom on this side also has a shower that's separate to the toilet with a shower screen to stop the whole bathroom getting wet. And there's opening port lights in every cabin. So this is the port cabin bunk beds. It's great for kids. The lower bunk is actually quite wide, can fit two people in it if necessary. Again, if you are making this cabin join to the starboard cabin and you've moved the center bulkhead, this top bunk will drop down to become a settee, so you've got seating on this side. Then by extending the double bed on the in the starboard cabin, you keep that door shut, and this is your door for entry when you've got it set up as one large cabin. Just moving forward, you've got the bathroom, and you'll notice you can see all the way forward to the skipper's cabin. So this bathroom is shared with the skipper, if you have one, or your kids. And again, there are shower screens, curtains to keep the shower dry and keep the toilet dry. This is an optional upgrade to go to the skipper's cabin. Ordinarily it would be a sail locker without any furnishing. If we look up, you'll see the hatch to the foredeck. This is where you can bring asymmetric spinnakers through the hatch or whatever head sails you need to remove or change when you're at sea. There's ocean air blinds on every hatch, which enable the boat to either be blacked out or it enables it to be a mosquito screen. Right, we're down the aft end of the saloon where the companionway is. This is where you'll find the main engine, the 140 horsepower Volkswagen engine. You can see the twin alternators for charging the battery banks, and quite easy to see water inlets and all the important features of the engine. There's also access to the engine from both port and starboard sides by opening little hatches. And on this, in the owner's cabin, you can remove a complete hatch to get right around the back of the engine. You can access the filters and the dipsticks, pretty much everything you need. So that makes servicing quite easy. You can do it yourself if you want offshore, or you can wait until you're in a port and have someone do it for you, a technician. The Volkswagen engines, there aren't marine service centers all over the world, so Cummins will service these engines and provide parts as well. So if you're in a place without Volkswagen Marine, you look for your Cummins dealer and they'll help you out. So that's the tour of the Jeanneau 57 hull 106. It's a 2013 model. Boat's name is MIMU. The engine hours as of July 2015 are 400, thereabouts. We're just about to head offshore to Fiji, where they'll be sailing most of the way, and spending a month or two, and then heading back to New Zealand for September. I'm Jason Snashall. Any more information, email me, jason@arikimarine.co.nz. or go to our website www.arakiyachtsales.co.nz. Thanks very much.